Good morning, everyone. It's Saturday, about 10 o'clock this morning. I just woke up. I'm still pregnant. And yes, this is what I look like when I wake up. So this just is it. I sleep on one, two, can't see the other pillow, but I have to sleep on three pillows. Otherwise, I feel like I'm suffocating. I haven't laid on my side in over a week now. It's just so uncomfortable. I had some contractions throughout the night. A few of them woke me up, but they're still not consistent enough. So, it's story of my life. She had been doing a lot of moving. I think she's trying to turn from sunny side up to face down, but I know her head is engaged some, so I don't know if that's what's making it difficult for her, or if she's not turning clockwise and trying to turn counterclockwise. I'm not sure, but I wanted to show you guys that my two-year-old still sleeps with us. And look how much bed is left. And look what a pregnant lady is at. So, yeah. I'm literally on the edge of the bed. Literally. This is my spot. I get the edge of the bed. You can't get it. I don't know. And I don't know what I'm going to do. How I'm going to get her out this bed, because I've been trying to get her out for months and she keeps coming back some kind of way. But I love her so much and she's such a good sleeper when she sleeps in. But I breastfeed and I usually do co-sleep. I know it's a big no-no, but it makes life easier. But I did get the rock and play. I got a rock and play. So it's set up right here. So I have it. So I'm going to try that first before I put in a bed. I'm going to try to do right. And you guys can see her crib is over there as well. I brought that in the room. That's the crib and a rocking chair. We put that in the room this time. Just because I didn't want to put her, if I did get her sleep in the crib, I didn't want her outside the room because, you know, my older daughter has autism. And then with the two-year-old, I can see her climbing into the crib, messing with the baby. And then my daughter with autism, I can see her, if the baby crying or something, trying to feed her or change anything, pick her up and drop her. So for peace of mind, we're going to try to put her in here and see if we can actually get a baby to sleep in the crib. Now, this is baby five. It's never happened. So, it's not, the odds are not in our favor. Plans for the day. I don't have any official plans, but I'm about to get up and throw some clothes on and run by my mom's house for a few minutes. So, I'll be getting back with you guys in a minute.
So, you guys, I did get up. I left the house. I wanted to show you why. What was worth it? I don't know if y'all have the Izzo's where you guys live, but look at this. These are my nachos. We have beef, free fried beans, rice, onions, cilantro ranch, salsa, corn, lettuce, tomatoes, pico. So that was worth leaving. I got some queso. Let's see what else. Okay. Some nothing but cakes. Let's see, red velvet. Oh, got two red velvet. And I got two lemons. And I also got some Starbucks caramel macchiato. So we're about to eat that real quick. But I just wanted to show you guys what was worth leaving the house for a pregnant woman.